Hey guys, so we're back again with another episode. We left off last time with the wiring loom just in the car, just run loosely. Nothing's connected up as yet. We've also got the rear subframe mounted. We were just waiting on rear calipers. And we've got the front subframe built up, ready to go on the car. So hopefully today we'll get that wiring loom run, and then we can start putting the dash in, putting the roof lining back in, start getting that interior looking a bit better. We're going to get the front subframe mounted, and we're going to get the rear brakes on and get some wheels on the back. That way we can drop it down, we can put a bogey under the front, and we can slide it then out from the ramp, so we can start putting doors on and stuff when they come back from the painters. So first job is we're going to crack on with them calipers and get them built up. So off our original calipers, we've got the original sliders. We're just going to give them a bit of a clean up, ready to go on. Sliders now. Nice clean up. I'm going to mount them first into the carriers. So we've got our little rubber boots. Pop that onto the slider, and then we're just going to give it a little bit of grease. Smear that all around, not too much, because we don't want it packing up. It's also important to use a silicone based grease, not copper grease. Basically that will react with the rubbers. Pop the sliders in, twisting them as we go down. Make sure it spreads it all around. Pop our rubber boot off, and there we go. Put that down to the other four. Thank you. That's all four pins greased up. Very now it's fit. Our first caliper. Tiny bit of thread lock on each of the bolts. Doesn't need a lot. Slider's moving freely. We'll build the other side up now and then we'll get them mounted to the car.
So I'm going to go for fitting the rear brakes now. All our gear set up. So. Calipers fully built with some new pads. Spring clips. So we'll crack on with that. So the pads now fitted. Seal to our pipe. Do just crack the bottom sides back off so it can spin. Where we can get the horse tight and in the right orientation. No rear caliper fitted. Still got the handbrake cable to do, but we've not got that at the minute, so we're going to bolt the wheel on now just so we can move the car about. There we go, one side complete. We're going to do the other side now. I've had a couple of weeks off, so I'm now back and we're going to attack the car again. As I said, the loom's in the car, but it's not actually fitted. So we're going to make a couple of repairs on the loom, rewrap it with loom tape. Fit that to the back of the dash, up the air pillars, get all that loom in place so we can start refitting the interior. We've also got the front subframe to go on, and then we can look at trying to get the car sat on wheels off the ramp, and then we can try and get some panels bolted up to it. So we'll crack on now with the inside doing the loom and see how that goes. As you can see, we have got the loom into the car now, roughly where it wants to go. The hardest job, I think, is going to be to get the loom up the air pillars, because you've got your drain off pipes for your sunroof. So what we're going to do, we're going to feed a wire down, just one piece of wire, just so we can hook the loom to it and drag it up. And then we're going to start repairing the loom across the dash. We've got a couple of bits where we've had bits added on, a couple of bad connections, so we're going to re-solder all them, heat shrink and make that all look nice. So yeah, we'll get some wire down the air pillars now and try and pull them up. So this is the loom that goes up the air pillar, feeds to the rear end and then to your interior light and clock. The tape is a bit ripped on it, so we're going to go ahead and tape that up with some loom tape.
piece of wire. I'm going to feed down. Hopefully that's going to come out bottom. And you're simply to put.
So as you can see, we've now got one end out, one end at the top. So I'm going to tape our loom off to make sure it's not tangled around any of the wires. So I'm just going to tape it as a hook. So that's now our loom taped up. We've taped the plugs up as well, just so they're not dragging and getting caught on anything. So we'll go pulling that through now. Hopefully it all goes to plan. Actually went a lot smoother than I anticipated, and we now have this side of the roof loom in. So we're going to go across the dash, behind the dash area now, do any repairs, get that all pinned up. So we have got a couple of, so we've got one broken cable here, which is going to need re-pinning. We'll go through all the connectors as we're plugging stuff in, and repair anything that's needed. Front of the car, we've got a few repairs on these wires where it's had multiple, it's had things added to the mobilizers and stuff. The previous soldering isn't the best, so we're going to look at repairing all of that. So it's not the easiest thing to get a shot of whilst I'm doing it, but there's basically where it's been chopped into, so we're just going to tidy all that up. Got our little gas gas soldering iron, our heat shrinks. So we'll crack on and do that. I'll come back to that in a minute once it's done. And yeah, see how that goes. So we have now repaired the loom to the ignition. We've re-soldered all them joints, heat shrinked it and loom taped it, and started to loom tape the main section of loom. which we're now going to start putting into the dash and working out roughly where everything goes, get it into a rough spot, and then we can start mounting the dash.
Start, we'll get the main section of loom now mounted up. Of our clock wiring, we've got various relay wiring here, and the switches right inside of the dash. This one, because it's a new loom, we don't need that relay anymore, because that one is still mounted to the car. Onto the dashboard. We've got the stereo loom, which is going to need a little bit of work. Someone's obviously had a aftermarket stereo in at some point, so we'll remove all that, put that on the standard DIN plug. Same with the speakers, neaten all that up, and then we can just plug and play the stereo. We've got it all the way to the left hand side. We have our heated screen loom, which now needs to go through the bulkhead into the engine bay, and then we'll work on getting our second set of wiring up the air pillar, and then we can run the looms down the side of the sills of the car, the final bits, and then we shouldn't be too far off then with the loom side. So our heated screen loom and separate from all the other wiring so it's not entangled. Yep, Me do it.
So, I'm going to do the other loom down the second air pillar. So I know old second loom now. So now, spin the camera around. So we're now looking roughly where we want to be, the loom. We've got our sides to obviously clip in. So we're now going to get this front subframe mounted up to the car. Got our subframe now sat on the bench for all our fixings, so we're going to go for lowering the lift down. Hopefully everything slots into place, get that bolted up and get the suspension legs in. So we'll go for lowering it down now. Lift job. Bit
get that bracket on there now. See that?
Yeah, it's always.
Oh, it don't tickle, tickle, does it?
Main subframe is now on. Shockers are bolted in and our top mounts are done up. I've still left the track rods loose for when we track it at a later date. For their anti-roll bar, because it obviously is under pressure, what we're going to try and do is bar one side up. So we're just going to bar that whilst we bolt the other side on. That should bring it into line then. And we can bolt the other side.
So that's it for today now, guys. We've got the front subframe on. We've also just put the front brake pipes, so the brakes are all connected up now. We've just got the little pipelines that go to the calipers and the calipers to go on when we've refurbished them. So front subframe, anti-roll bar, new poly bushes, shockers are now in, top mount's done. We've also got the loom on the interior. So hopefully tomorrow we'll do a bit more on the loom, start running it to the back of the car, clipping it up. So yeah, we'll see you tomorrow. So unfortunately we've not managed to do much else on the Cosworth. We've spent a couple of days getting ourselves ready for Christmas and having a bit of a tidy up around the workshop, fixing a few bits around here. We've also managed to acquire a couple of blasting machines. So we've been repairing them. What we're going to do, we're going to fill this one with a coarse media. This is going to be for brake parts, etc., where pitting's not really an issue on them. And then we've got another machine which we're going to set up with a ceramic based media. That'll be for the smaller, finer stuff, so we don't damage the metal as much. So we've got them set up, we're going to have a play about with them and hopefully have them fully going for the new year. We've also got another project which I'll take you for a look at now. So what we have here is a Jaguar E-Type, which is going to be having the full Mad Mechanics restoration. Although it does look a bit worse for wear at the minute, the actual chassis is solid and straight. We need to get this on a jig and get it pulled out, and then we can start the resto on that, get it panelled up, get it painted, and have it looking brand new. So that's it from another episode. Just like to say a massive thank you to everyone who's subscribed to our channel, who's liking and commenting. Hopefully there'll be much more content to come in the new year, and we'll get a few more cars in, get the COSY finished and move on to the next one. As always, please like, please comment, please share, and we wish you all a Merry Christmas and we'll see you in the new year.